Every little grain is a jewel waiting to be discovered. This is sand from California on Big Sur. And you can see that there it's essentially made of different kinds of minerals. So this is olivine. Olivine is one of the that green stuff. So this is a green sand beach in South Point, Hawaii. Now these are grains of sand from Maui, Hawaii, from one little beach in Hawaii. And there's just a ton of different stuff in there. A lot of this is biologically, you know, in Hawaii, a lot of the sand is biological in origin. Look at the very top there. You see the top, that green thing? That's a little tiny baby sea urchin spine, a tiny, tiny bit of a sea urchin spine that broke off. The white part of it attaches to the bottom of the sea urchin. Just to the left of that, there's this round thing that has this interesting sort of design in it. That's a foraminifera. One of the things about foraminifera is it's a good way to tell where sand is from, because different foraminifera live in different ecological niches. That Y-shaped thing at the very bottom, that's a really interesting thing. That's a glassy sponge spicule. And the sponge spicule is the internal skeleton of a sponge. If you look down at about 3 o'clock, there's a bit of a shell fragment. A lot of stuff is shell fragments. Okay, you see this stuff that looks like glass?
Yep.
That's quartz crystal. Most of the sand on the earth is made of quartz crystal. Now that quartz crystal, that's the stuff that's used. The computers we're using right now, the chips in the computers are made from very high quality quartz crystal. Glass, good glass is made from quartz crystal. And concrete is made from quartz crystals. And it's becoming a dwindling resource. All the deserts are quartz crystal. Now they're highly eroded away. They don't have the sharp edges anymore. And some sand for construction and so forth, you don't want them totally round. You want some sort of sharpness and jaggedness to them. But the great thing I learned about sand is the extraordinary nature of ordinary things. The sand is a snapshot in time. You can take a bit of sand from somewhere and understand the entire ecology of that area, both the land ecology and the surf and the ocean. The sand is a record of thousands and even millions of years of geological and biological time in that spot.